In Regula-Falsi, if we have a continuous curve and we can find a point x1 and point x2 such that the function values of x1 and x2 give a y value with a positive sign and a negative sign, that must mean that that between the two of them, the graph intercepts the y-axis, and we can find a value for the root or where y is equal to 0. The way that we do this now is that we assume that from this point on the left, the x1 value and the x2, where the y is negative and the y is positive, we can draw a straight line between these two and work out the equation of this line, find the intercept at that point, so we interpolate to find the point where we intersect the axis. At that point, we then find the new value, and this just happens to be on the y-axis, it's not always going to be like this. We find a new point on the y-curve, and if that point is also negative, we discard the original guess, and we use this new point as our x3 value and replace it with the negative value. If we'd found that this point was a positive, we would have discarded the positive value. We now carry on iterating and now find from this new x3 value, we find a straight line between x3 and x2, and we carry on finding new points x4, and each time we discard the point that has the same sign as this new point. Okay, so we've given a step-by-step account of how to do Regula-Falsi. The first one is going to be to choose or guess a value x1, and we are going to guess a value as step 2, but we have to guess these values so that the signs are opposite. So if we find if we guess x1, we can find the fx value, and we can find, the fx1 value, the x2, but as I say, the signs must be opposite. So one gives a positive y value, and one gives a negative y value. The next step is to include linear interpolation. So we are going to just do linear interpolation between these two points. Okay, those are the two points that we've chosen in step 1 and step 2. From this, we are now going to find the new value, x3. And to find that, we are going to use the linear interpolation, where the linear interpolation graph cuts the x-axis. So that's the point where it cuts the x-axis, and that will now become our new our x3. The next step is to discard one of our original values. So we want to discard the value either x1 or x2 that has the same sign as x3. So it's the same y sign, not the x sign, not the value of x, this is the value of the y. So if it has the same y value, then you discard either x1 or x2. And then the sixth step is to simply repeat using either the using the x3 value as well as the value that you found in step 5. So that's either the x2 or the x3 as you found from step 5. And then you can repeat this, and the gap between the x1 and the x2 will get smaller and smaller until the x values are the same, and that will be your final answer for the root. The only mathematically challenging step in this is going to be the linear interpolation, and it's still fairly simple, but let's just go through that step anyway. So the linear interpolation for the Regula-Falsi is going to be that we need to know point 2, so we're going to start with point 2 and point 1. So if we look at the function values of point 2 and point 1, and we subtract them and divide it by the x values of point 2 and point 1, that will give you the slope of the graph between point 2 and point 1. And if we do the same thing for the slope between point 3 and point 1, those are going to be the same. So it's the fx3 minus fx1 divided by x3 on x1. So that is going to be the slope of between 2 and 1 and between 3 and 1, and those two graphs should be the same. But what we want to find is where the f of x3 cuts the x-intercept. So that means where y3, so that is what f of x3 is equal to 0. So if we have y3 equal to 0, that means that in our graph, the f of x3, that is this value here, is going to fall away because we are now assuming, or we want to calculate where that is 0. If we now rearrange and simplify, we can there write that therefore the x3 value minus the x1 value is equal to the following. Negative f of x1 multiplied by x2 minus x1 divided by the function values, minus x1 on the top divided by f of x2 minus f of x1. And if we simplify that down all the way, and I'm not going to do all the steps, we get that, and sorry, that's x3 minus x1. We get a final answer of x3 is equal to x1 minus a y1, so I've replaced the fx value with a y value y1, multiplied by x2 minus x1 divided by y2 minus y1. So that is just simplifying it and converting the fx values, which I see I haven't put brackets in properly here. It's taking the fx values and moving them down into y values instead of fx. So that is the linear interpolation that you will need to use for Regula-Falsi. Okay, so having a look at an example quickly of x3 plus x minus 5 is equal to naught. If I want to use Regula-Falsi, how do I go about this? So I'm going to start, and in a test and exam, you're probably going to be told this. Otherwise, you just have to guess. So I'm going to guess, or well, I've done this before, so I know that the x1 value that I want is 1, and the x2 value I want is 2. If I find out what is the fx value of that, so fx of 1 and fx of 2, which is the same as y1 or y2, the values for that come out as minus 3 and 5. So important to note that the first step was, do I get a negative and a positive value for the two guessed x's? And I see I do, so then I can carry on with my initial guesses of x1 and x2 as 1 and 2. Okay, so once we have that, we now need to use, to calculate rather, our x3 value. And that was from the linear interpolation where we said that the x value x3 was going to come from x1 minus y1 multiplied by the x2 minus x1 divided by y2 minus y1. If I put all of those values into the equation, we get a value for x3 equal to 1.375. More importantly though, what happens if we get the f of x3 or y3, and if we put that into the original equation at the top, the x3 plus x minus 5, we get a value of minus 1.025. So we now have three sets of values, x1, x2, and x3. So those values there, so x3 is 1.375. In terms of the y values for that, we have a negative 3, a positive 5, and a minus 1025. So because we have a negative as our y3, we now need to discard our original negative y value, so we discard x1. We are now going to look at using y2 as well as y3 in our next step. So the next step, we now look at what would x4 be. So x4, we're again going to use the equation for the values that we had. So we have x4 is going to be equal to x3 minus y3. So you'll see in this equation the original equation of x3, we had x1 and y1. We replaced x1 and y1 with x3 and y3, so that's why we now move them down, replace them in the equation we are using. Okay, so if we carry on, let me just try and rub that out and neaten it up a bit. So we have x3 minus y3 is then going to be multiplied with x2 minus x3 divided by y2 minus y3. So wherever we had y1s in the first iteration, we now replace them by x and y3 because that's what we replaced it with when we saw the positive versus the negative number. Calculating that, we now get an x4 value equal to 1.481. The f of x4 or y4, when we calculate that, then becomes negative 0.271. We go back again and look at our values. So there is our y value in blue. So let's try and just, I can't squeeze it down anymore, sorry. So we're now left with our three sets of values as x2 and x3, x4 in the red circles. So we now see that our new x4 is a negative. So we need to cancel or get rid of, discard the x3 value because it's also negative. So we have a new negative value. Our solution is now lying between x2 and x4. So it's somewhere between 2. It's between 2. So x2 was 2. So it lies somewhere between x2 of 2 and an x4 of 1.481. And now we must carry on doing this until we find a value that is close enough together to assume that that's our final root. So if we look at the full set of results, we started with x1 and x2, where we guessed the values of 1 and 2 to give us the y values, and you'll see there was a negative and a positive for that. Moving forward, we went on to x3, which gave us a negative value, so that meant we crossed out x1 and only used x2 and x3. X4 again gave us a negative value, so we had to discard the negative value line above and use x4 and x2. And as we work down on this one, you'll see that in this example, every time that we used a new x, they were all negatives. So what that meant was that every successive line, we used the positive value for x2 as well as the one above it. And by the time we get to x11 and x12, you'll see that the values are starting to sit around 1.5160. And that the y values are starting to get fairly close to zero, even though they are in negative values. However, the Regula-Falsi method is telling us that the value is still sitting somewhere between 1.561 and a value of 2. In this instance, however, we can clearly see that the y value is closer to zero at the value x12, where we're getting a value very close to zero, where it's times 10 to the negative 6. So we can assume the value, even though it's between 2 and 1.516, is a lot closer to 1.561. If I had to do this again, I would guess a different value instead of 2. I would guess a value somewhere closer to 1.5 as our positive value, so it's probably 1.52. And if we did that, you might see a jump between the positives and the negatives to give your final answer.